Good morning, students. Here I am going to teach you the word problem, this word problem, from the exercise. That is question number 8 is that there are three types of coin. One, rupees 1, rupees 2 and rupees 5. The total amount is rupees 300. And it is given that the number of rupees 5 rupees 2 coin is 3 times rupees 5 coin, and the total number of coins is equal to 160. Total coins is equal to 160. Let rupee 5 coins be x. Now rupees 3 coins is 3 times rupees 5 coin. That is 3 times. So rupees 2 coins, number of rupees 2 coins will be equal to 3x. Now I have the total number of coins is equal to 160. So rupee 1 coins is equal to 160 minus x minus 3x. That is 160 minus 4x. Now the value of these 3 coins is equal to 300. Thus, according to question, the value of these 3 coins is equal to 300. So according to question 1, that is the one value of 160 coin, 160 minus 4x coin is multiplied by 1, then rupees 2 coin is multiplied by 3x, and then rupees 5 coin is multiplied by x, that is equal to 300. Now what will be here? That is 160 minus 4x plus 6x plus 5x is equal to 300. 6x plus 5x, that is equal to 11x. 11x minus 4x, 11x minus 4x is equal to 300 minus 160. Then 11x minus 4x is equal to 11x minus 4x is equal to 7x. 7x is equal to 140. Now x will be equal to 140 by 7. That is 20. Number of coins, rupee 1 coin. Minus 4x, that is equal to 160 minus 4 into 20, that is 160 minus 80, that is equal to 80. Rupee 2 coin is equal to 3x, 3 into 20, that is equal to 60. And rupee 1 coin is equal to x, rupees 5 coins is equal to x is equal to 20. Now if I have 20 coins of rupees 5, that is equal to 20 into 5 is equal to 100. 60 rupees 2 coins is equal to 60 into 2 is equal to 120. And 80 rupees 1 coin is equal to 80 rupees. 80 plus 120 is equal to 200. Plus 20 into 5 is equal to 100, that is equal to 300. So our answer is correct. How I have done? That is, total number of coins is 160. Let the rupees 5 coin be x. Number of rupees 2 coins, that is 3 times rupees 5 coins, that is 3x. And rest will be the rupees 1 coin. That is, the total number of coins is 160 minus x minus 3x. That is 160 minus 4x. Now I solve this one. and I got x is equal to 20, so rupees 1 coin is equal to 80, rupees 2 coin is equal to 60, and rupees 5 coin is equal to 20. That is your question number 8. Then question number 9. Wherever we are discussing the question number 9, question number 9 is a fractional problem. A fraction is always expressed in the form of numerator divided by denominator. So some relations will be there. Is it clear? And according to that relation, we have to solve the problem. The problem is that, the question is that the denominator is greater than numerator by 8. So denominator is greater. So I will write, let the numerator be x, let the numerator be x, and the denominator is 8 more than the numerator. So the denominator is equal to x plus 8. Now our fraction is numerator by denominator. So the required fraction is equal to x by x plus 8. Now some conditions will be there. That is, what is that? Well, if the numerator is increased by 17 and the denominator is decreased by 2, the fraction becomes 3 by 2. That is, the numerator is increased by, according to question, the numerator is increased by 17 and the denominator is decreased by 2. Decreased by 1, then the fraction becomes 3 by 2. Now what I have to do here, 8 minus 1 is equal to 7, x plus 17 divided by x plus 7, that is equal to 3 by 2. Now what I have to do, I have to cross multiply this one. So whenever I cross multiply, then we get x plus 6, 17 is equal to 3, x plus 7. Now 2x plus 17 to the 34, 3x plus 21. Now the like terms are taken in one side, that is 2x minus 3x is equal to 21 minus 34. So that is equal to minus x, 2x minus 3x is equal to minus x, and 21 minus 34 is equal to minus 30. So this one is cancelled. So x becomes x is equal to 13. So our fraction, original fraction was what? X by x plus 8. X by x plus 8. X is equal to 13, and 13 plus 8 is equal to 13 by 21. That is our answer. Now what is given here, that if it is subtracted by 1, then it will become 20, and if it is added by 17, then this one will be equal to 30. 30 by 20 is equal to 3 by 2. So I have checked this one. This one is correct, enough. So you understand this one. Now we are going to the question number 10 and 11. Two questions I am going to discuss with you. Two questions I have discussed. Again, this one is also a fractional problem. I am just giving you the mathematical expression for this question, and you have to solve this one. The numerator of the rational number is less than its denominator by 4. Let the numerator is equal to x, and denominator is less than its denominator by 4. So denominator will be x plus 4. Our fraction is equal to x by x plus 4. Now what is the condition given here that we have to study? That if the numerator and denominator is increased by 2, the rational number becomes 5 by 9. So numerator and denominator according to question that is increased by 2, x plus 2 divided by x plus 4 plus 2 that is equal to 5 by 9. So by cross multiplication we will write 9 x plus 2 and here will be 5 x plus 6. Now you will solve this one. You can solve this one. 9x plus 18, 5x plus 30. Then you have to solve this one. 9x plus 2 and 5x plus 30. 18 will be shifted there. 30 minus 18 that will be equal to 12. And 9x minus 5x is equal to 4x. 4x is equal to 12. X will be 3. And now x, if x is equal to 3, then this one will be 3. And this one will be 7. Your answer will be 3 by 7. You have to do yourself this question. Then the last question we are coming here. Right? This one is upstream and downstream. What is upstream? Whenever a boat moves against the direction of the stream, then that is called upstream. Whenever a boat moves in the direction of the stream, then what may happen? It is called downstream. So here is the one question is that a boat goes downstream and covers a distance between 2 points in 5 hours. While it covers the same distance in upstream in 5.5 hours, find the speed of this boat in still water. So we have to find out the speed of the, here is 2 points, A and B. Whenever we are going from A to B, the distance is B, and whenever we are coming from here to here, the distance is same. The main thing is that we have to keep the distance safe, and then we are going to solve. Let the speed of boat, let the speed of boat in still water be x kilometer per hour. With the stream that is downstream, downstream the speed will be speed of boat will be equal to x plus 3 by 2 means 1.5 kilometer per hour. Upstream speed will be equal to x minus 1.5 kilometer per hour. This one we have written. Now you come to the next, that is distance is equal to speed into time. So in downstream that will be the distance will be equal to 5x plus 1.5. upstream distance will be 5.5 hours, that is equal to 11 by 2 x minus 1.5. Now I have told you that the distance is same. So according to question, what may happen? According to question, that is 5 x plus 1.5 that is equal to 11 by 2 x minus 1.5. Now come to the next part, that is 5 to the 10 x plus 1.5 that will be 11 x minus 1.5. Now 10 into x is equal to 10x, 10 into 1.5 is equal to 15, 11x, 11 times of 55, and 11 was 11 and plus 5, 16.5. So what may happen here will be 10x minus 11x is equal to minus 16.5 minus 15. So here will be equal to minus x will be equal to minus 31.5. So minus is cancelled here. X is equal to 31.5. Speed of boat. In still water is equal to 31.5 kilometer per hour. That is your answer. And your chapter is completed. 12, question number 12 will be your homework. Is it clear? Now, thank you.